Here's how to use a for loop in JavaScript. I have an array here of the names of the colors of the rainbow. And what a for loop will do for you is it will allow you to perform operations to each element in a list. So in this array, we have a list of elements. You can see here there's 7 of them. And a for loop will allow you to do the same thing to all of them. Or make decisions based on all of them on different criteria. But a for loop basically will go through each item in the list and does whatever you tell it to that item. So let's do this here. For is how you start a for loop. And these are the two things we need. So here is where the for loop starts and stops. All the code inside of here will be executed each time around the track, each loop, each lap that we do in the for. It will do the code that's between the brackets. And here we need to tell it 3 things. We need to tell it where to start, where to stop, and what the unit of measure is for each time we go around the loop, each time we have a lap on this track. So how we do this is we say variable I for iterator. Iterator just basically means counter, equals 0, because we're starting at 0. Every array starts at 0 in JavaScript. So there's like a hidden index here that you can't see, and it just counts from 0 starting with the first element. So we start our iterator at 0 so we can grab this first element and do something with it, and then we just continue on adding one each time. So here's where we're to start. We're declaring I is a variable that equals 0. Where to stop would be the name of our array, typically, dot length. And so what dot length does is it says, look in this array and tell me how many items I'm dealing with here. What's the total number of items or elements that are in here that we're going to deal with? And so this basically you have to say I is less than the amount of elements that we have. And the reason for the less than is because it starts at 0. So like if you were to count this, as a human, you would count it starting at 1 and go to 7. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. But because a computer starts at 0, we want I to not be bigger than 6. So instead of being 7 and starting at 1, it's going to be 6 because we start at 0. See how that works? So there's I equals 0, and I is less than 7 is what we want. Okay, so this will equal 7 because there are 7 elements. That's what the length will do. So it will stop before I equals 7, which will stop at the end of this because that will equal 6. Hopefully that made sense. And the last thing we have, where to start, where to stop. And the last thing is how many to increase our counter by each time we run through this. So I plus plus, we're waiting for the website, there we go. I plus plus is basically the same thing as saying I plus I, or I'm sorry, I equals I plus 1. And what that does is it adds 1 to I and then keeps the value of I with the extra 1. So that basically just adds 1 to the number. What this does is it says I plus whatever number up from there, another, you know, so if it's 5, it turns into 6. If it's 10, it turns into 11, whatever. So that'll increment. That's why it's called an iterator, because it iterates and it counts up by 1. So that's what that's going to do. That will add 1 to itself. So now in here, just to kind of illustrate that this actually works, we're going to say document.write, and write does not have a queue. What we're going to do then is say, all right, grab an element from the array, and putting these two brackets, oh, see, it's already printing stuff at the bottom here. It's printing constantly because we're telling it the whole array. If we just put in an I, it'll just print each one of these. So each one of these words is going through the for loop one time. To better illustrate this, let me just add a line break here in HTML. So it will, okay, there, now it prints them all on their own line here at the bottom. So you can see that they're all being printed. To prove a little bit further that we are actually running through this loop, let's do this. Let's say, as I is, and then we'll put the value of I so we can see what it was. All right, so this red, oh, let's put another space here. Okay, so red as I is 0, orange as I is 1, yellow as I is 2. You can see that it's outputting that value of I, And it's increasing itself here. The I is increasing itself. And then it's stopping before it gets to 7. So I never equals 7 in our equation here. So that's how a for loop works. And it is very useful, very powerful. You can do all sorts of things with a for loop. You can add two numbers together inside here. You can perform all sorts of operations. You can search for things. You can change the text in each of the elements. Whatever you want to do, really. Whatever you need to do in a for loop. But due to every item in the list, you can look for items and then say, oh, this item does equal this criteria, and you can keep track of how many items in your array. There are easier ways to do this, by the way, but as an example, you can keep track of what is in the array by going through each element. If that's something you need to do, you can use a for loop to do that. So I hope this made sense.